bus home from work today, the moon caught my eye. This sadly happens fairly infrequently now that I live in a city. It's usually just too bright out for the moon to catch my attention like that. So with the moon on my mind, I thought I would share with you a couple fun things about the moon. Thing one, Earthshine. We see the moon because it bounces light off of the sun and down towards us. The phases of the moon are caused by the relative Earth-Moon-Sun geometry and not by the Earth blocking part of the moon, but that's not what I'm here to talk about. The moon functionally doesn't emit its own light, so we only see it via the sun's light, except for certain circumstances. When the moon is a tiny crescent, you will see the illuminated sliver lit by the sun's light, but you will also see a faint, faint outline of the rest of the moon. Where's that light coming from? Well, light bounces off the Earth just like it bounces off the moon, and some sunlight can bounce off the Earth, go to the moon, bounce off again, and come back to the Earth, allowing us to see the whole moon even during a small crescent. This is called Earthshine. Thing two, the dark side of the moon. Turns out there isn't one, a dark side of the moon, that is. The moon is in a special gravitational arrangement with the Earth. It is what we call being tidally locked with the Earth. So as the moon orbits the Earth, it rotates in such a way as to always show us one and only one side. The far side of the moon is the side that never faces it. It gets plenty of light, we just don't see it. That was one of the special things about Apollo 8, the mission that for the first time brought human beings to the far side of the moon, letting us see part of our celestial sibling for the first time. Thing three, the last solar eclipse. One of the cool things about physics is its power to make predictions. On Earth, long-term predictions are hard. Because of friction, air resistance, and a million billion other things, it's hard to make millennia-long predictions about the motion of objects. But astronomical bodies in space, those are basically spherical cows in a vacuum. No air resistance, no friction, so we can calculate the positions of planets and moons almost indefinitely. This is how we know exactly when solar eclipses will happen years into the future. So the last total solar eclipse was back in 2017. The next will be this July, but visible from South America. Moving way forward in time, there will be a total solar eclipse visible in Iceland in 2026 and Mozambique in 2046. Moving way forward into the future, there will be a total solar eclipse in eastern Russia on March 31st, 2424. You could do this forever. Well, not forever. Turns out the moon is moving away from us. Slowly, but steadily. A couple centimeters per year. And once the moon gets far enough away, it will no longer look big enough in the sky to block out all the light from the sun. At some point, we will no longer have total solar eclipses. There will be a final solar eclipse. But some 600 million years into the future, not tomorrow or anything. I do think, though, that it's kind of sad. One of the many slow tragedies that play out on cosmic timescales. But it kind of makes the eclipses we have all the more special. The total solar eclipse is a phenomenon made possible for a couple billion years, but one that will eventually fade away.